the net, so too has John Gappart, but they haven't had the backup that they've required. And that has led to impressive individual stats, but a poor team record. It's the end of the line then for Trinidad and Korea. Both have lost 4 out of 4. One of them has to end with a win. It is a basement battle to avoid the booby prize in Pool C. Who will finish bottom? Who will finish on a high? Korea to start on serve with Ha Yo-hee Lee. Nice goal denied by the Korean block early on. The combination of Hua Lee alongside her captain. What a start for the 18-year-old. The block gets the score as it deflects out of bounds. Trinidad and Tobago get their first point and get back level. And now we have a serve for Crystal Esdil. The second most experienced player on their roster coming into this competition. And she serves up an ace. And Trinidad and Tobago take the lead. Of course, none of them experienced at this level. The very first major world level competition for Trinidad and Tobago in their history. Loop to the back corner. Impressively by the 21-year-old Jai Yung Lee. 11 points against America on Tuesday, but she scored just 7 of 36 spike attempts. So far, yesterday she was 1 of 7 against Russia. Long but got a touch, so Trinidad take the lead, although Korea don't think it did. They do have the option to challenge if they so choose. Jai Yung Lee, the number 17, just read out her attack kit stats. She's one that will be disappointed to not have backed up Yong Kawon Kim and John Gappart a little more. It's a good hit from Mua Lee, who's now got a block and a spike to her name, the 18-year-old. Two of Korea's three. She's got an ace as well. Hua Lee. Three of Korea's four, doing a bit of everything. An ace, a spike, and a block. Lovely adjustment at the net from Sinead Jack to tip it over the top of the Korean block and tie us level at 4-4. She's really improved the longer this tournament's gone on. Didn't play too well the first two matches. Didn't score double figures, but the last two, 14 on Tuesday and then 18 yesterday. Very close to an ace there, but just beyond the baseline. Converted 12 of her 20 spikes yesterday. En route to that 18-point game against Azerbaijan. She had 3 stiff blocks as well. Making a misconnection with the left hand, and Korea by 2. Drilled to the backcourt by Shannon Thompson. She's able to get up and running, Trinidad's best scorer. And Trinidad able to get level from two down. They are a big team, and they had a little bit too much height and athleticism at the net there. Thompson's tip. On the move to score off the block, Soo Ji Kim. Stepping up at the net. She's their best blocker, but very much capable of that as well on the move. Thompson again across court. Tipped over by the captain, saved by Alton for the second time in the rally and drilled down by the lefty, Crystal Esdal. Trinidad back level again. The next point will take us into the technical timeout, which comes when the leading team hits eight. Wonderful serve from Thompson. We're just about dealing with it. And come back strong themselves, safely on the baseline. There's the set. And there's the finish from the Korean superstar, Yong Koon Kim, to take them into the technical timeout with a slender lead. Perhaps the rally of the match so far.
Hey, carefully with in the line. In the line is all too. It is alert about that. It is tip or roll. Okay, ladies, yeah, let's go. Go.
Hey, we have this. Let's go. Hey, good trip.
It's you.
The first point in the match for Yong Koon Kim. Esdal, Thompson and Ramdin each have two for Trinidad and Tobago. Soo Ji Kim next up on serve. Off the back of the timeout, continuing on serve to try and keep Korea in front. And she can't. Another Ramdin right hand, three now for her. Talking of players who might have stepped up a little more for their team, she's certainly one of them, Darlene Ramdin. Jeonga Park getting on the board. So it took the first 7 or 8 minutes, but Korea's two big hitters are now both up and running. Fielded down the line this time by Hyo Hee. Yong Koon Kim stopped. Here she goes again. Backcourt attack from Thompson finding a way through. Shannon Thompson already has three as well. Emphatically by Huali. Not for the first time, the teenager coming up big on the block. Tremendous start from the 18-year-old here. She's got 3 points already. John Gappart reaches it on the stretch to help it over. A big chance to set for Ramdin to try and find the baseline, and she does. Well, Darlene Ramdin up to 4 points, which has been her total in each of the last two games. Quite remarkable. Only 5 of 23 on spike kicks across the last 2 days. And here she is with 4 of Trinidad's first 10 after only about 10 minutes. John Gappart will get a second bite of the cherry. Thompson to drill one. Shannon Thompson gives Trinidad and Tobago the lead with an absolute dagger. Four for her as well now. John Gappart with a right hand that's too hot to handle. Career level at 11. And the ace on serve. The second already for Uha Lee. Well, the future looks bright for Korea. If they haven't been brighter this tournament. John Gappart getting the touch off the block. And Korea have opened up a rare 2-point gap in this first set, which has been very tight. Off the left hand of Sinead Jack. Thompson firing one off the top of the block to continue her impressive start and to make sure Trinidad and Tobago remain in touch. Saying it got a touch. I think they're going to ask for a challenge here. The point awarded to Trinidad. Yes, they are. The signal goes up from Coach Chahai Wan. John Gappart, the third top scorer in the tournament. Started a little slowly here and now she's found her feet, hoping for this point. She is up to 3 points already. Is it going to be four? As it stands, Trinidad and Tobago are level from two down, 13-13. There's a good long look at this one taking place. And a long way for those Koreans looking up in hope at the big screen. It's close, but there's no touch. ブロックタッチはありませんでした。13-13. Sinead Jack to serve. And what a serve as well. Trinidad and Tobago have scored each of the last three. Sinead Jack now has three, and Korea, to try and turn the tide back in their favour, will call a timeout.
Minimum two or three, and after you can to change, yeah, come back again.
Hey, two, three, Nico.
Well, all of their big players have stepped up so far in the first half of set one. 5 points for Shannon Thompson, four for Ramdin, two each for Jack and Esdal. Jack to continue on serve here. Almost another ace from her, well fielded by the Korean captain. A chance for them to get on top in the rally now. And a set right on top of the net for the drive from the far side from Soo Ji Kim. Really good serve reception from Yongko and Kim to give Korea that opportunity. It was the other Kim that finished it. Oh, right into the corner from Shannon Thompson, who can't miss right now. 6 points already. Rifles one back to the baseline and gets career level. We only had a 1 point lead at the first technical timeout. We're only going to have a 1 point lead at the second technical timeout as well, which comes when the leading team hits 16 points. Who's going to have that lead? John Gapart to serve. And to serve an ace as well to take us into the technical timeout with career back ahead. It's been a really entertaining first set between the bottom two teams in Pool C. John Gapart catching fire now. 5 points for her.
The ball is for a side, don't swing. Keep waving, keep waving. Okay.
Well, this is certainly a first set that looks like it's going to go down to the wire. The best opportunity and the last opportunity for these two nations to pick up a win at the World Championships. They're battling to try and avoid bottom place in the group. And you can tell they both want it. 16-15 career now. John Gapart to serve again. Away over the top of the block to tie us back level once more. Big strong connection, not strong enough though, despite a bit of penetration leading forward over the net. Squeezed through the arms of Yongko and Kim. Much on that serve from Shannon Thompson. His team ever so slightly behind once more. And a change for Korea. Ji Young Oh coming in. And out goes Soo Ji Kim.
Oh!
commanding across court. What a game she's having. Only 4 points in each of the last two games. She's got five already here in the first set. In comes Kyoune Fletcher, the 16-year-old, to serve here. And to serve too long. She's the youngest player on any roster here in Pool C. She's not had too many seconds on court. She won't get too many more. And she goes back to the bench. Talicia Ross out as well. Oh, tremendous serve from Ayohee Lee. We've seen some really good serving from here at these championships. And Trinidad and Tobago in a spot of bother here, down by two late on in set one. They're going to call a timeout to talk things through.
The first timeout by Trinidad and Tobago.
Is this the point in the set where Korea open up a significant lead? Yes, it is. Rammed in. Trinidad and Tobago's top scorer shut down on the far side by the double block. Huali again. What a set the 18-year-old is having. That's her third stuffed block. Jackhammer from Sinead Jack. An emphatic way for Trinidad and Tobago to get back in business. Some TNT dynamite. And they'll serve the ace as well. They've closed the gap to one. Off the serve of Crystal Esdup. It looked to be Korea's for the taking, not anymore. That one too long though, off the left hand of Esdup. Korea 4 points away from that targeted 25-point mark. Over the top and down just about from Sinead Jack, despite the best efforts of the Korean defense. Caught the top of the net and was close to the number 17, Jae Young Lee. John Gap Park scores again. Six for her now. Suji Kim is back in for Ji Young-ok. Thompson taking off and finishing. Shannon Thompson, a huge tally of 8 points in the set. Yeah! Lovely touch from Jeong Gapart, showing she's not all about power. A touch of finesse here to loft it over the top of the double block into the open spot on the floor. Trinidad 23-21, Korea timeout, Trinidad.
Second timeout by Trinidad and Tobago.
Except number six, the hand is high, is deep. Everybody move, because they are continue doing. Okay? Everybody in your area, but move it to everybody. Okay, ladies, let's go now. Go.
Hey, do drink.
And their team haven't often come close to winning sets. 21, 11 and 12 against Russia. Their tallies, 21. Here against Korea, still falling short. They didn't score more than 11 against the US. They've only won one set out of 13 so far at the World Championships. There's a fault, they're up to 22 in this one. They did get 27 points, remarkably, against Azerbaijan yesterday, but lost the set 29-27, only 16 and 17 over sets 2 and 3. Well, they're back level here, 23-23. It's only the third time across their 14 sets so far that they've reached this many points. This first set could be absolutely crucial come the end of this match. Two out of form teams, two teams with no wins. What a confidence boost it would be to go ahead. Oh, that one right back into the corner for the ace. What a point. What a time for a captain's contribution. Ronald Ford takes Trinidad and Tobago within 1 point of winning just their second ever set at the World Championships. Can she reproduce? Jeong Gapart saves the set point. Korea's big hitter stepping up when it mattered. 8 points in the first set for the number 13. Drilled one down the line, back to the captain Ford. And now we go to first to 26. Well, that's a captain's contribution for Korea. Yong Ko Un Kim gives them their first set point. She's left the scoring up until then to Jeong Gapart, but took matters into her own hands. Just a second point of the set. And the big block will finish it as well. The captain with a defensive contribution after the big offensive spike. The most significant 2 points of the set from Yong Ko Un Kim. A big player stepping up at a big moment. And Korea take the first set 26-24. Tough to take for Trinidad, who lost one 29-27 to Azerbaijan yesterday, and then here today to start 26-24. So close, but yet so far. Welcome back to the Kobe Green Arena, where at Korea have just about forced themselves over the line to win the first set against Trinidad and Tobago. And Yong Ko and Kim with the most significant say in the end. Two of her 3 points in that set, the last 2 points, to finally put them to the sword. Now, as has so often been the case in their first ever World Championships, Trinidad and Tobago have to pick themselves back up and go again and try to fight back from a losing position. They had one set point that was saved. They had set points against Azerbaijan yesterday that were saved. They've still won just one set ever at this tournament. They've got a minimum two more opportunities to try and win another. They do want to get their first ever win for the World Championships. You feel they have to take this set. What chances of coming from two down to win three in a row, having only won one of their first 14? Well, picking up right where she left off, Yong Ko Eun Kim. She scored Korea's last 3 points. Right hand hook to the chin of Trinidad and Tobago. John Gap Park. Korea's two big hitters scoring the first 2 points of set two. John Gap Park now within touching distance of double figures, 9 points. She's level with Shannon Thompson as the leading scorer in this match. Brandon squeezing one down the line, didn't catch a piece of it, nor a piece of the blockers, so three in a row for Korea. How close was this? No, not close enough. Drill to the back corner. Much more accuracy, much more power that time from Ramdip. 6 points for her, which has already matched her highest tally. It over. Korea a big chance to set on the net. Clutch back, tipped into the block though, kept alive and tipped over. Alton almost saved it. but great instincts and quick thinking from Uatli. She's continuing to show that perhaps she should have had more minutes in this championship. The teenager, 6 points now. Only Jeongap Park for Korea has more. So from Yong Kwon Kim, too long. Struggled yesterday after a strong start. And a second time as well, the two number twos going toe-to-toe above the net. Jeongap Park, inevitably, is the one to decide the rally. 10 points for her already. Alongside Jae Young Lee. What a start to set two for Korea. And one that will force Trinidad to call a timeout early.
The first timeout by Trinidad and Tobago.
Don't put the body behind the.
Promising performances for so many in Trinidad Red in the first set, but all of their big hitters shut down so far here in the second. A dangerous Uatli to serve. Fault on the Trinidad side of the floor, and a 5-point Korean lead. A body shot delivered by Shannon Thompson. After 9 points in the first set, she finally gets her first of the second. A rare bit of joy for Trinidad in this set. The mark as she took off above the net. Usually would bury those in that position. Good adjustment from the defense to cut down the shooting lanes. Block, but deflecting out of bounds, and Korea reached the technical timeout with a 4-point lead just beyond the line off the right arm. Hevestel.
Stereos.
Okay, let's go, go.
Hey, go drink it, yo.
Well, it was a watertight first set. He's still keeping it tight. And they're both technical timeouts, only down by one, but this time they're down by four. Korea finishing the first set the strongest and starting the second set the strongest as well. Jae-yong Lee to serve. John Gap Park couldn't squeeze it home. So line one up and have another go. This time goes to the back of the court. And there's no touch. A rare miss hit from her. I thought about the challenge, but decided against it. No touch from the block. What a serve that was. It might well have been travelling in. Yong Kong Kim was taking no chances. A snapshot from Suji Kim stopped at the net. Estel only firing into the net though with the left hand. Career by four. Did the block get a piece of this? John Gap Park was there. Let's see. No, just straight into the net. Shot serve reception from Ramdin gives Korea a 5-point lead and gives John Gap Park an ace to add to an already impressive stat line. Her dig in the backcourt as well. Tipped over for the score by Yong Kong Kim. Korea by six are really pulling away now. Trinidad and Tobago will call another timeout to try and right a few wrongs here.
Okay, hey Lee, you need to push a little more on left. We need to pass, we need to pass a little more. The pass it is not bad, but it is necessary. We can say push more, there is more block. It is the player need to move in the block and look for the ball. Not the player, front of the player, full time. Okay, let's go, go.
Hey, go straight!
Hey,
where's
the block line?
It's the largest deficit that they've had to face so far here this afternoon. What can Trinidad and Tobago do off the back of the timeout? Joust to the net, and too strong is the Korean captain, Yong Kong Kim. She's chipping in with the odd big point here and there. Up to six now. Off another impressive serve from John Gap Park, who's got 13. Kellyanne Balinji coming in for Rennell Ford here for Trinidad. John Gap Park remains on serve. Nice throw, denied. It's Korean cruise control here in Kobe. Yong Kong Kim getting up and slamming the defensive door in the face of Crystal Estel. Found a way through that time, fielded in the backcourt though. line up another, and she'll get rejected again by Yong Kuan Kim. She got one-on-one with the Korean, but it didn't make a bit of difference. Drilled it past the double block that was forming that time for the backcourt defense from Jae Yong Lee. And then one-on-one, Yong Kuan Kim was the one who came out on top. Clever and clinical finish that time to force it past that impressive Korean block in that front left position. Jalicia Ross. A rare point for Trinidad after Korea had opened up a 9-point gap. And they very quickly and emphatically do again. Soo Ji Kim with a super spike over the top of the net. Another Korean point. It's a double-digit lead to take them into the technical timeout. Absolutely dominant. This big piece of defensive work at the net for Korea coming from Yu Ah Lee, the 18-year-old who previously had scored just 5 points across the first four matches. The official stats here are saying that she's got five. I think she's up to eight now, in fact. I think something's not updating there. We're seeing 5 points for the number two for Korea. Three stuff blocks, we know that that is the case. Not seeing any spikes, I'm sure she's converted two. And I know she had two aces as well. Challenge for this serve. The original call was correct. Through by Jack, buried against the number 17, Jae Yong Lee. Bang! And Jack up to 6 points. The technical timeout for Trinidad. Having trailed by 10, they've got back within 7. The high reach of the net of Kellyanne Balingi. It's going to cut the run short though. The wayward serve of Esdal. They need to deal with the very capable serve of Hye Yo-hee Lee. Got the chance to set against the block though. Clear to get on top in the rally. Soo Ji Kim lining up on the far side. John Gap Park down the pipe to deadly effect. Back to a 9-point lead. John Gap Park up to 14. On serve as well. She's served so well through this tournament, Hanyo Healy. Her first ever World Championships at 38 years of age, and she's certainly been one of those to stand out. With a big right hand. 7 points for her off 7 spikes. Where on earth was this kind of performance the last couple of days? Stops it on the baseline, Thompson sends it back over emphatically. The gap reduced to 8. Shannon Thompson's tally increased to 11. Trinidad, we've not seen too many of those. Sinead Jack getting up on the far side to give their fans something to cheer. It's just their second point of a stuff block in the match.
We need to control the ball over there. And remember, the player jumping here and outside is here. Okay, there, you are from. Look at the distance. Okay, okay.
Come in! Goal!
Their 10-point lead cut down to 7. A timeout called by the coach, Chahai Wong, to try and help Korea see it through for a 2-set-to-love lead. 12 appearances at these World Championships for Korea, and the first time ever they've started with 4 straight defeats. How badly they want to put that bad run to an end. John Gap Park with power down the pipe again. Up to 15 now to lead all scorers. She's again on the far side, fielded in the backcourt. Thompson to flex up off Hayo Healy. Helped over. Thompson will come again, but can only fire into the net. And Korea, thanks to that brilliant backcourt defense, are up by 9 and only 4 points away. Back-to-back points off the back of their timeout. Through from Rambin, who's certainly enjoying her last performance at the World Championships. Yeah. fingertips. And in the end, it was enough to baffle the defense. Korea only 3 points away from taking the second set now. 1-2. Quick reactions from Trinidad, not quick enough. So from the impressive Uali into the net. 8 points for the 18-year-old. After only five across the first four matches. She goes to the bench. So too does Kellyanne Balingi. Rennell Ford, the captain, comes in to serve for Trinidad. John Gap apart to the back corner with power. She has been a consistent threat throughout. 16 points now. 20.5 is her average through the tournament. Beaten on the block that time. And Shannon Thompson tipped it over the top. Shannon Thompson with 12 points is already above her average of 11.8. Trinidad's leading scorer on serve now. Rattling the top of the net. John Gap Park gets it to go and extends her tally once more. 17 now across the first two sets, and it brings Korea 9 set points. She really has got back in business. John Gap Park only converted 14 out of 61 spike attempts yesterday for 23% efficiency. She's been efficiency personified so far here today. Serve off the mark means Korea will have to wait. Ah-Yohee Lee back in place of Ho Young Jung, the 17-year-old who came in just for that 1 point. That will do it. As was the case in set one, Yong Kwon, captain, finishes off set two. Captain Courageous puts Korea up by 2 sets to love. They took the first with a bit of a struggle, 26-24, having to save a Trinidad set point, but they take the second far more comfortably by 9 points in the end, 25-16, and now one set away from their first win at these World Championships. Welcome back to the Kobe Green Arena, where the captain once again for Korea put the finishing touches on a win for them, 25-16, far more comfortable in set two. 5 more points off attack hits, a couple more on block, 2 aces to 0, and points even of errors of the opponent. Only Japan and China have competed at the World Championships more than Korea, their 12th appearance in this prestigious competition. Not the way they would want it to end here at the first stage, but at least they're going to go out on a high as it stands. No such luck for their team. Still just one set won from Trinidad and Tobago across this whole campaign. It's the second time their team have won two sets. Of course, they lost in five to Thailand, which was at the start of their downfall on opening night. Now they'll try and win a third set for the first time at these championships. And that would see them finish fifth in Pool C. They're also looking to end a six-game losing streak, stretching back to 2010 at the World Championships. They concede the first point of set three. It was a really good start to set two for Korea, going in at the technical timeout up by 4 points, 8-4. Trinidad and Tobago know they need to start better here in this must-win set, and they have done for now. Just to the net, the rally goes on, tips over the top for two. Trinidad have responded. Triple block. Korea's top scorer stopped down the pipe. That might be the first time that she's been stuffed on. It was the left hand of Sinead Jack. Just about kept alive off the disappointing serve reception. Chance for Randy now to waterfall down inside the block. Trinidad and Tobago taking charge at the start of the third. As the 18-year-old Uali wasn't tight enough to the net. Stop the run, and it's Uali who responds. Korea Bong can't put together back-to-back points in this set, though. Really disappointing start. Certainly uncharacteristic of what we've seen over the first two sets. John Gatapart just about getting it to go off the tip as Trinidad tip it out of bounds. Serve reception as well, so Korea given some encouragement. Three aces now through Ali. And she goes again to try and provide another. Too long that time. Trinidad and Tobago by three. Gap Park off the top of the block. There's a fault here. It's going to be a career point. It would have been anyway. And now Ford seeing her elbow catch the net. Esdol squeezing one home. And Trinidad and Tobago keeping up their little bit of breathing room. 1 point away from the technical timeout now. Takes them there. This was the score the other way around at the technical timeout in set two. Now it's Trinidad who have the lead and a platform from which to build. They will continue to cheer on their team for as long as they possibly can. They're hoping they'll get a fourth set. Those Trinidad and Tobago fans, for just the second time across the five matches, giving themselves a chance, leading by four as we come back off the first technical timeout in set three. Still a long way to go in this third set. Plenty of time for Korea to come back. Wow, the run goes on and on and on. The captain's ace from Rennell Ford. One before the technical timeout and one straight after it. Timeout called by Korea.
It's only for remember. Jump to the ball, look for the ball, open the finger, look for the ball over there, alert darling, alert in position taken.
Come here! Four!
Three points for Rennell Ford now with all of them on serve. She was the player unable to field that last one, Jai Yong Lee. Rennell Ford might be aiming for her again. Let's see. Lee Ran Kim gets in the way. Hopped into the near side. Jong Gao Park, dug out by Alton. Thompson to tip it. Across to Jong Gao Park again. Alton is there again behind it on defence. Shannon Thompson against the block. Somehow kept alive, but not for too much longer. Boy, did Korea have to work to try and get that point on the board. Alton first to everything. Finally beaten by the ricochet. Serve floats wide of the mark from Jong Gao Park. Korea need to improve a little more. Down by five again. Well, that was a wonderful serve from Shannon Thompson, just to force the defense back. And from there, the Korean offense was easily intercepted. Trinidad knew exactly what they were going to do.
Oh,
Thompson with similar power but not similar precision on the next one. Yet another point for the impressive Darlene Ramdin. She's up to 13 now. She's on course perhaps to score as many here today as she has in the previous four matches at these championships. One back from Korea, from Uai Lee, who's already scored more today than in the previous four. Only 5 points across the first four matches for the teenager. The official stats have her with 9 here today, but I think she's unfortunate not to have been credited with at least a couple more. 5 points the deficit for Korea again. Now Yeon Lee into serve. What a big return from Jack. Set right on top of the net. Jack could have missed from there, but she made sure it stuck. John Gap Park down the pipe, gets it out on the near side. One-on-one block. Trinidad have to help it over with emphasis from Esdal. And tipped cheekily in the end by Yeon Ko-won Kim. She's been nowhere to be seen in terms of scoring in this third set, the Korean captain. Not until that moment. They need her to step up now. Rather than stepping up, she's going to go to the bench. Ji Young-ho comes in. To tip it and to help it up. 5 points the gap between these two. Ramdin again found the line with unerring accuracy. Everything she hits turns to points. Squeezes one through, past the block and the backcourt defence. 5 points the gap again, but Korea at some stage need to go on a run. They have Uai Lee on serve now. She's already scored 3 aces. They could do with the 18-year-old continuing that fine form on serve. And there's another one. Just what Korea needed. Four points the gap for their team to try and overcome now. Double figures for Uai Lee. Set on top of the net for the emphatic finish from Jack. No chance of building momentum on serve for Lee that time. Trinidad and Tobago 1 point away from the technical timeout. Really good serve equally as well dug out. John Gapart attacked it quickly to go off the top of the block. Beyond the backcourt defence and pull Korea within 4. She's up to 22 points now, Jeon Gap Park. Only 2 players in the tournament have scored more. Kept alive here in the backcourt. Backed up towards Jung Gap Park again. Looking set right on the net. This time, Jalicia Ross puts the finishing touch on it with the right hand. Trinidad into the technical timeout with a five-point lead, 16-11. So close to winning just their second set ever at these championships. Shannon Thompson leading the way for Trinidad with 13 points each, but it's been a real team effort here in set three. Sinead Jack is up to 9 points for them. Estel has four. Renal Ford, the captain, has three aces. A couple of them in the run that opened up the gap for Trinidad and Tobago here in set three. Jalicia Ross with 3 points. The last one gave Trinidad a five-point lead. Trungar Park over the top, down the line, but didn't find the line. And it looks as though there's every chance we are heading to a fourth set. They're still 8 points away, Trinidad, but they lead by six. It's a long way back for Korea from here, and they know it. Look, John Gap Park stopped by Alton, comes back high above the net. Kept alive. Korea wanted the fault, and instead Trinidad and Tobago get the finish. Estel hammers it down the line. We are going to have a look at the video, though. A challenge requested from the Korean bench. They are going to spark some kind of a comeback. Well, this is a big call for them. It's about communicating what they're looking for here now. The challenge, I think, is for a net touch. First referee having a word with the official Jongya Park. It is going to be a Trinidad and Tobago point. Disappointment for Korea. They're down by seven now. Trinidad and Tobago only seven away. Soo Ji Kim finding a way through for the first time in a while. Jongap Park will serve next, Korea's leading scorer. Ji Yun Rok comes in. They keep finding a way to force their way through. Crystal Estel with the left hand slicing across court off the block. It's another cut to Korea. Shannon Thompson with a tremendous serve. What an ace from the number three. Watched and whacked back to the baseline. Trinidad in charge.
We need to block that talent in the block. Look for the ball. Open the finger and look for the ball over there. Hey, because anytime you do it that, it is the army. Anytime they are in front of the.
Trinidad only 5 points away now from taking just their second ever set at the World Championships. And Shannon Thompson has had a huge say, 14 points now, including an ace on that last one to force the Korea timeout. They lead by 8, Trinidad, and she will serve again. This time can only find the net. He certainly won't be celebrating anything this early. The defense. Yonko and Kim has to help it over and helped it over for the score. A miscommunication on the Trinidad side of the floor. She did not expect a score from that one. Should have been a chance for Trinidad to get on top on the rally. Instead, they concede the point. Goal, found a way through with the left hand. Just to put that disappointment of the previous point behind them. 4 more points required for Trinidad and Tobago. The one set that they have won out of 14 at these championships came against Thailand, losing 3-1. They won that single set 25-23, Trinidad and Tobago. So this really is uncharted territory for them, leading by 6. And somehow they get the point off that serve reception. Korea look crushed. Everything falling for Trinidad right now. That really should have been a chance for Korea to get on top in the rally. Kim to help it overhead, go to the backcourt for the score by Yonko Ung Kim. Korea will fight to get as close as they possibly can to try and apply some pressure to Trinidad. They still have a sizable gap though in their favour. 6 points now the lead, and Trinidad and Tobago need just 3 more points. Still from the 3-metre line, stopped in the back by Yonko and Kim. John Gaphart found a way through, back within 5. A little bit of pressure starting to build on Trinidad, and their coach will call a timeout to try and alleviate that pressure. See this one through. John Gaphart taking her tally to 23 for the match as Korea closed the gap down to 5. Will their run go on here on serve? Oh, the block just wide of the line. Fine margins. But now a fine opportunity for Trinidad and Tobago to secure this second set, this third set rather, as it comes off the number 2. She just didn't penetrate enough. Huali. That one finds a way through as Lee responds. Trinidad and Tobago had one set point in set one. Can they force what would be six set points here in set three? No, they can't. Accepting the gift above the net was Suji Kim after the shank serve reception. Noah Lee, one of Korea's better servers, remains on the baseline. Too long from Thompson, and Korea are creeping up towards Trinidad and Tobago. They're back within three, and Trinidad call a timeout with the wind in the Korean sails.
We, anytime there is up, because anytime is hard. We need to lose the ball, but there is a, you have a block, everybody have a block. They are blocked to everybody. Look for the block, hard. Okay, we need to one pass.
Trinidad, the only one of the 24 teams here at the finals in Japan, making its competition debut. They're trying to stay in with a chance of winning their first match at these championships. They need to win this set. Pereira back with it too. Again, it's Huani on serve. Remarkable run from the teenager. 13 points for her now. Little to no room for error. The set to John Gapar to drain one at the feet of the defense. Korea back within one. What a time to go on this kind of a run. They trailed by 7 points at 20-13. Shannon Thompson rejected, kept alive by Alton on her knees. Thompson haps it up into the lights. Korea to steady the ship. Jeongap Park to try and tie and does. The Korean comeback complete. They have clawed it back from seven down. 23-23. A remarkable run on the serve of the 18-year-old Duali. Now, can she help get them ahead? Who's going to have the set point here in set three? It's Korea! Korean Seoul coming to the forefront down the stretch. A big time block as Suji Kim combines with Jae Yong Lee. Match point, Korea. Seven down in set three. Korea win it in straight sets to end a run of six straight defeats at the World Championships, stretching all the way back to 2010. Jeongap Park, the leading scorer. But the run on serve from the 18-year-old Huani Lee down the stretch did the damage. A double-figure performance from her. Trinidad and Tobago have to accept five defeats from five and only one set won on their World Championships debut. It's the end of the line for both teams here, but Korea at least go out with a win. And what a way to finish. It will make the flight home a little easier to digest as they contemplate ultimately a disappointing campaign after making their way back to the World Championships for the first time since 2010. Korea led by the 26 points of Jeongap Park. 12 more than anybody else on court in this one. 13 from the teenager Hua Lee, including a number of aces down the stretch and big serves to rock Trinidad and Tobago back and provide the chance for Jeongap Park to seal the victory. They have 9 from their captain, Yuan Kowon Kim. And Trinidad so, so close to winning a second set. They conceded a set point in the first set and then a 7-point lead in the third set. 30 minutes that first one, 26 and comfortable for Korea in the second, and then nearly half an hour again in the third. A really entertaining first match on court here in Kobe on the final day of the first stage of the 2018 FIVB World Championships. Trinidad and Tobago had 14 points each from Shannon Thompson and Darlene Ramdin. It was the latter's most impressive game of the tournament so far. They had 9 from Sinead Jack. But it's those Korean fans celebrating come the end of the game. And one final chance to show their appreciation to their team and likewise for their team to reciprocate. And they've at least given them a win to finish. Jeongap Park will end as one of the top scorers in the first stage, but of course will not be able to add to her tally anymore.
First win on Here's last day of a tournament. How do you feel now?
Yes, we had a really hard tournament in this year and also in World Championship. And we are expecting to go like second round, but we are a little bit sad about that. But anyway, we finished with the win, so I'm happy for that. Yeah.
What did the team Korea learn from this tournament?
Actually, yes, we wanted to go second round. That I said, this was our goal, but we couldn't make it, so it was a little bit sad. But we are, our goal is going to the Tokyo Olympic 2020, so we will work for the Olympics for it. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Yes.
Indeed, a disappointing campaign for her and her team, but ultimately they end with a little bit of joy as they win their final match, led by the 26 points of Jeongap Park. Sets win for Korea here in Kobe. And before we leave you, we'll look at the final positions for Korea in Trinidad and Tobago. Korea avoid finishing bottom. They can't get into the top four no matter what happens today. So that is the end of the line for both of these two teams here at the World Championships. Azerbaijan against Thailand to come next. Then it's the big one, the USA against Russia. It's been a pleasure having your company here. Thank you for being a part of the game.